The six-part Health in London report from the King's Fund is the result of 18 months' work and hundreds of patient case histories. It says Londoners' health is no worse than people in the rest of the country, yet healthcare in the capital costs twice the national average. Despite that, waiting lists have been growing, and there's concern that pressure on beds has led to high cancellation rates for surgery. At Hammersmith Hospital, one in five planned admissions is cancelled. Other shortcomings include rigid ward regimes, poor food, and inadequate arrangements for admissions. The report also says people whose first language isn't English have trouble understanding the system. In general, many Londoners are dissatisfied with the quality of the care they receive and have poor access to services.
The acute services really don't meet the needs of patients. That they're often organised for administrative convenience or for the needs of the people who run them, rather than really starting from where it should start, which is patients and people who need to be patients.
So what can you do about that?
Well, there are two things that we think are really important. One is there certainly needs to be a London-wide strategic body to look after the planning for Londoners' healthcare as a whole and not to have the fragmented system that we have now. The second thing that we think is most important is that users of health services should be fully involved in the planning of those services, and only that way will we really have an appropriate service capable of meeting needs.